high definition. This is KCAL 9 News at 2.
Seems like nobody hides it anymore. A lot of celebrities admit that they have had collagen, Botox, or other injections to look what they call refreshed. But there are some other ways that you can rejuvenate your skin. Plastic surgeon Dr. Ashkan Gavami is here, and he's going to share some of his secrets to help us look. And you know what? When we look better, we feel better, too. Yes. Doctor, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So people are starting a lot younger to see plastic surgeons, see their dermatologists and estheticians. When you're in your 20s, is that too early to be thinking about improving your face?
No, there's really no chronological age recommendation. It's just a matter of what your anatomy and your face is doing. And lifestyle affects it too. So if some 21-year-old college student is coming to me and telling me their lifestyle is that they drink every weekend and they're dehydrated or they smoke cigarettes, we first start with that. Mm-hmm. It doesn't make sense to plump the lips up with Restylane or some other filler and then have them go and dehydrate themselves every weekend. So that's important, lifestyle. In addition, I have patients, for example, that have one eyebrow that works a lot stronger than the other, so they have an asymmetry. So I'll do Botox to even out the arch of their eyebrows. And a lot of things are preventative. So not everybody has nice full lips, and it's not an aging issue. Some people just have like not a good contour to their lips when they're even 19. So as long as they're over 18 and with the lifestyle changes, little by little fillers can prevent. Botox can prevent deep wrinkles from ever forming.
Really? So you can use it as a preventative?
Exactly.
All right, let's take a look at some before and after pictures. I know we've got a few of those, and we'll show the folks what's going on. So facial refreshers, it looks like maybe the left side of the screen is the before picture?
Yes. This patient had a lot done, actually. She's an older lady. She actually has a twin. And she had what I call a deep plane facelift. So she's in her 50s. We did a deep plane facelift. I restored the volume in her face with fat injection. And so one of the signs of getting older is losing volume. When you're younger, you can restore that with fillers that come in a syringe that you can buy in the office. As you get older and the skin and muscles separate, mm-hmm. you can't just rely on plumping it up because then you overcorrect and people look like balloons. And we've all seen that walk around.
Yes.
So you can't overcompensate. So for someone like this, you got to restore her neckline. You have to restructure the face and reposition the deep structures. And then the skin lays back down without any tension so it doesn't look pulled and artificial.
We see a lot of improvement there in the jawline and the neck on this patient.
Exactly. And her cheekbones we restored and brought vertically up. So it's really important to really know as a surgeon or a dermatologist, when is it time to go from non-surgical to surgical? And that can be at any age. The youngest facelift I ever did was 38 years old.
Wow.
And it's not because she was necessarily old looking, but she had premature jowls. Just because of her anatomy, she lacked bone structure here. Mm-hmm. So her cheeks looked flat and she looked tired when she wasn't. So in order to just go fill her up, that wasn't a long-term solution. She wanted restructuring, and so you do a facial shaping procedure to accomplish that.
As we get older, we start to see those lines, and no amount of creams or drinking water is going to help when you're in your 30s and 40s. As you start to reach the older age, you mentioned that the injectables don't work anymore.
No.
What sort of things should we be doing at home to alter our lifestyle to prevent that? Is it taking the makeup off at night, the kind of pillow you sleep
in? Well, you know, some people first of all, sun exposure is key. And you know, here in Southern California, who doesn't like the sun? But the problem is, you know, if you're in the sun a lot, you dehydrate your skin further. You cause these tiny little crepey lines to form under the eyes where the skin is the thinnest and has less resilience to battle the harsh rays of the sun and the damage it causes. Plus, people get discoloration. So they have like, they look like fatigue uniform, their mm-hmm. face. They have like five different colors, blotches, wrinkles. So you resurface the skin. There are peels you can do at home yourself. They're not as powerful as your dermatologist or plastic surgeon can do for you. So in conjunction with like a facelift, we'll always do a peel to resurface because it's like creating this beautiful couture dress and then having it be wrinkled and not steamed out. So you want to resurface the skin at the same time reshape the face. So if they're limiting sun exposure, they're hydrating with their favorite cream, and some of the over-counter ones are okay, but usually the strongest ones you get at the doctor's office. And something with the retinoic acid in it, like a Retin-A type product that's in there, even if a little concentrations, can really do a lot to tighten collagen.
That turns over the cells.
Exactly.
Makes you look refreshed. All right, doctor, thank you so much for being here. For more information about these treatments and a link to Dr. Gavami's website, just go to kcal9.com. We've got all the information right there. Click Scene on TV.